Thrivethemes versus Elementor. Which is better for you? In this comparison video, we're going to find out. Hi, welcome to the Hidden Online Living YouTube channel. My name is Peter, and in this video, I'm going to do a comparison on the Thrivethemes page building suite versus the Elementor page building suite, and give an overview of the differences between the two. So essentially, what are both of these programs? They are page building editing suites that you can use to create landing pages and different types of content for your websites. They have a whole host of different and unique tools and features that can actually help you to create content very quickly. So what I'll do is I'll just jump into my computer real quick and we'll get started.
Right, so here I'm just going to give a quick and brief overview of both of these platforms and how effective they're going to be depending on which one you want to use to create your content and your web pages, etc., for your business.
So we'll start off with Thrivethemes, first of all. Now, Thrivethemes is a collection of a load of different programs that can be used both for creating landing pages, even to a point where you can collect email leads and other features. The main feature here is Thrive Architect. Now, I personally, myself, I'm using Thrivethemes as well. I've a subscription to it because I use this as my main platform for creating my web content for like web pages, landing pages, etc. And we'll be using it for other projects and that going forward. So again, you've Thrive Leads. You can use this to create like boxes and etc. to pretty much try and capture email leads and create pop-ups and so forth. So you've loads of other ones as well. Thrive Quiz Builder, Thrive Team Builder. There's a load of different ones here. Thrive Comments, Thrive Apprentice, Optimize, Ultimatum. You just have to go through it when you sign up and it'll give you pretty much a whole suite of really effective and useful products that you can use to pretty much create whatever type of content you want for your websites and even implement them onto, like, say, social media, YouTube, etc. So here's a list of the products and so forth that you can use to get started. So just have a quick look at Thrive Architect, because this would be probably one of the main ones that you would opt into this platform for. So again, you can just go through each of the products and then you can watch the introduction videos, etc., just to get a brief overview of pretty much how you can get set up with each of the platforms, etc. And you can just go through the pages and that, and just pretty much just take your time and do a bit of research and understand what it's about and just take note of how effective it's going to be, whether you think it's going to be useful for you moving forward with creating a business. So you're down here down to the pricing section. So it's $19 a month, or if you want to opt in for a single license, $67, or it's $97 for 5 licenses that you can use Thrive Architect and up to 5 websites, which is actually very good. Now, obviously, this is like an annual thing as well, so it is fairly decent in price and very affordable to get up and running very quickly, especially if you have a bit more of a budget. This would definitely be worth having a look. So again, there's just definitely frequently asked questions, pretty much anything that you need there that you can have a look at. And even if you want, you can also become an affiliate of the platform as well, so you can earn commissions based off sales, etc., of the products and that are on this website. So I'll just jump in, I'll give you just a quick overview of some of the products, etc., just and how they can be used, because essentially it'll be used with WordPress. So I'm just going to go in and I'll just quickly show you. Alright, so just on my WordPress dashboard here. So when you do sign up, you will actually have to, you'll be sent a file that you'll have to download, and what you'll have to do is you'll have to install the plugin file. So you'll be able to upload it and then install it, and what you do, it will appear down here under product manager, and then you'll be able to literally install the pieces of software that you actually want to implement onto your site. So again, here it gives you a list of the type of products. Now I'm using Thrive Architect and Thrive Leads at the moment. I'm not using these ones here, but if I want to add them in, I can. I will do it at a later stage, but for the moment I only need these two just to get up and running very quickly. So then you can just literally go onto your Thrive dashboard and then you can check out different tutorials, and you can integrate different features, etc., like even autoresponders and so forth onto it, so that you can get up and running very quickly. So when you go into your pages, what you want to do is, when you're wanting to edit a page, once you highlight a page, once you have it installed, you'll be given an option to edit with Thrive Architect. So when you do, you'll be literally it'll open up this interface here, and then you can literally come in and you can add in different features. You can add in text, images, and everything is literally just drag and drop. So when you place it in, you can just edit it to your heart's content. And so you can add in different building blocks, custom menus, social features, progress bars, videos. You can embed videos on your pages as well if you want. And then it even comes with a load of preset templates that are actually very, very good. There's different sets that have different types of templates in each one based off the type of content that you're trying to promote. Whether you're trying to promote video, whether you're trying to promote blog pages, whether you're trying to even capture email leads. There's pretty much landing pages and templates here are pretty much suited to anything that you actually want. And again, these are all fully customizable as well. So when you click into one, you can pretty much edit the way you'll be able to edit the text and pretty much do whatever you want to do to make it your own. And again, what you can even do is you can also set up your own templates as well. So you can literally come over here and you can click on where it says settings, and you have different features here. So you can import landing pages, you can export, you can even save landing page. That'll save this here as an actual template itself. So pretty much here, this is one I've done before on a previous project where I was setting up to try and capture email leads. So you can edit it in. So clearly when you preview it, so if someone enters in an email, pretty much you will capture the lead and you'll be pretty much good to go, so you can promote to them then at a later stage. So when you've done all that there, it's just a clear case, then you can add in some of the other external features. So when you highlight on something, you will always get a list of different options and features that you can actually use to pretty much change the text, change the color of buttons, change size of buttons, even create like target links as well. So I've done where I've actually added in my Aweber. I've integrated my Aweber account, my autoresponder account into this. Again, I've previous videos that I've done on using Aweber and how to set most of this up. I'll actually leave links in the description to a playlist where I have actually a few videos set up where I've actually go through the process of creating all these features, etc. And obviously when you're done, you just click and make sure that you save your work. So when you highlight something, it gives you loads of different background. You can change the text again, like I said, change the colors, change the line spacing, change borders, change background style, even in adding different animations. Even when you're putting in links, you can create like custom animations, dynamic jump links, etc. Which is, there's a lot of really, really cool features in the program. But again, you just take your time with it, go through it, understand this, play around and have a bit of fun. But if you're stuck, there's plenty of tutorials. Even like I said, I'll leave the links in the description to a playlist that I have set up with some helpful hints and tips that'll help you get up and running. So feel free to walk away and have a look at it yourself and see if it's something that'll benefit you and your business. Right, so we'll just quickly move on to the Elementor page builder. And here I'm just on elementor.com. Essentially, it's very similar to what thrivethemes does. It has its own page builder, and again, it's very beginner friendly, and it pretty much has a lot of similar features in that to Thrive Architect, as I've shown previously in the video. And just going through some of the features, etc., that how it can be used and implemented with WordPress. And again, like thrivethemes, you can also become an affiliate of the program as well if you want to promote it, which essentially if it's something that you're looking to get into, it'd be worth recommending, because like thrivethemes, it is a very, very good product. So you obviously have a list of features like design, editor, marketing, so you can use it again to build very, very highly customized and effective web pages that can be used to promote your content and your business, etc. So when you just have a quick look at the pricing is different from the likes of thrivethemes. So it's $49 per year for one site, $99 per year for three sites, but the expert one, so it's just under $200 per year, and it unlocks a lot more features. So you can even set up like e-commerce websites with this page builder as well, and it allows you full access to WooCommerce, so you can personally integrate loads of really unique features to really add a lot of really good pieces to your e-commerce stores if that's something that you're looking to get into. But again, there's more than enough here, even on the free version, if you're looking to just set up like a blog and so forth. Now, unlike thrivethemes doesn't actually have like a free trial that you can actually use. Elementor actually does, so you can actually download it from the website here. Or what you can already do is, if you've already got a WordPress account set up, like say on your dashboard, whatever hosting provider you're using, whether it be Bluehost, Namecheap, or so forth, once you have the website set up, you just come into your plugin section and go to add new. And then over here on search bar, you can literally type in Elementor, and you can literally, it'll be the first one that pops up. And as you can see, it's got a lot of active installations because it is a very, very good and effective program, and it's very, very good for beginners. Now, it is the basic version, but it's clearly more than enough that you can use to get up and running very quickly. So it's ideal, especially if you're just starting out on a budget, or when you have little to no budget, this would be a very, very good tool to use. So again, let's have a quick look at the interface and how it's set up. So again, it's similar to like the Thrive Architect. Now, obviously, this is the free version, so there is some limitations, but there's more than enough features in here to be able to literally get set up with something very, very quickly. Now, clearly, just going down here, you will need to upgrade to the pro version if you want to unlock more of the content features, etc. But for the basic version, it's definitely a very good tool. I've also done a video previously on this. I have also done a video previously on this where I actually walk you through the steps of actually just creating a simple page or landing page. Now, again, with the basic version, it integrates to your current theme, so you can still edit certain features, but there's certain parts you can't do with the basic version. But it's still more than enough to play around with and create something unique and that looks really, really pleasing to the eye. So again, I'll leave a link in the description for that video, for that previous tutorial that I did, so you can check it out for yourself, and it'll give you a more in-depth overview of how to get started with this platform. But again, just looking at it here, it is very decent. You can add in different concepts, text, headings, drag and drop, and again, it's very, very easy to use. It's not difficult really to get set up with. So you can change like text, you can change the different structure positions, add in your own style. So when you want to add in sections, you can even link to like custom URLs, external URLs as well. So it's really, really good for laying out pages and have everything just clearly aligned so that it just looks more aesthetically pleasing, which is definitely worth taking a look at. And like Thrive Architect, it's very, very easy to set up and to use once you get the hang of it. So yeah, you definitely have a look at it, like I said, and play around with it. And if you're on a budget, maybe Elementor, maybe a bit for the starting point, maybe the when you're starting out and you've limited to no budget, Elementor would be a good piece of software that you could actually use to integrate into your business so that you can create content around, at least until you can eventually afford to upgrade to the pro version or even move on to something else like say Thrive Architect if you want. But again, this here is a very, very good starting point. But once you do have a budget, like I said, upgrade to more version, the higher version, and play around with it, have a look. Or if you want to use Thrive Architect, by all means have a look, because both programs will be very, very effective to get you up and running, create content and so forth, and make your websites look very, very pleasing. So again, I'll leave links in the description so you can check out the tutorials and even check out these websites yourself as well, and just have a look around and see which one will be best suited to you. So that's it now for this comparison video on Thrivethemes versus Elementor. Which is better for you? That's totally for you to decide. There are so many different features and tools available on each that will be beneficial to whichever one you decide to choose. A lot of it though can be down to budget, so if you are strict on your budget, then Elementor, the basic version, would be a good start. And the fact is that you can use it for free, and that you can easily install it from your WordPress dashboard without any hassle through the plugin section, as I showed in the video. Thrivethemes, even though you do have to pay for it, but when you get everything set up, and especially if you opt in for the additional plugins and features, etc., you have a whole plethora of tools there that can really amplify your business to a point where you can see results fairly quickly. But again, both have their pros and cons, but they're both equally valid and essential programs, especially if you're wanting to create content, whether it's say for blogs, any type of website, e-commerce site. They would be vital in your push to really see the growth on your business over time. So hopefully you found this useful review to be helpful, and if you have, make sure to leave a like on the video. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you're made aware of future content. And also feel free to share the video. Also, are you looking for a way to figure out how to actually get started in your own online business and need some sort of avenue or path to follow that will actually get you up and running very quickly? Make sure to check out that first link in the description and the pinned comment for a simple and effective step-by-step blueprint that you can use to help get you up and running very quickly. Also, make sure to check out some of the other reviews and tutorials, etc. that I actually have on my channel for easy and simple step-by-step guides that can actually help you create the content that you need to grow your business. And I will see you all in the next one.